Hello my friends, welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Artem Voronov, I'm lighting designer and DIALux EVO trainer. In this video I'm going to show you how to make daylight calculation and daylight analysis in DIALux EVO, and we're going to make this project. And to start this project, let's open up our file from our previous tutorial. You can find this file in our Telegram lighting design community chat. This is how our lighting design international community in Telegram looks like. So some people ask questions and work with DIALux EVO and work with lighting design, and we help each other answering to some questions. So thank you that you're joining this community. First of all, let's start with this file, and with our daylight analysis we work with windows. So you can draw these windows with this tool. You go into this part and then click to select, and then you should choose this window standard, not window roof, but window standard. Okay, and then drag and drop it to your file. Make sure that you work in this first story. Okay, let's hide our drawing, and then using the scale tool we're going to make this window here. Okay, and let's go to our 3D view. Let's type here 0. Here we're going to make the height of our window. It's going to be 2.7 in this project. 2.7. Okay, and I also use this frame width. I'm going to put this 0.05. yeah, and let's go to our top view. Click to our window and let's click to Ctrl C, Ctrl V and drag this window. So we're going to make three of this window. Okay, and I advise you to leave this some space, not to scale it over this part. So this may cause some problems in future with your geometry. So we're going to leave here some space. Usually when you work with your daylight calculation, you should choose your location, or even you can type here some coordinates if you know it. So this is the coordinates of location where your project is located. And then here you have north arrow, and I'm going to draw my north arrow here. I'm going to put here my first point, then second point, and here in the left corner you see the orientation of your north arrow. If you don't have this arrow, you should go to these settings and select here this button. Then you can save your project, and then I'm going to the light folder, and I'm going to this light scenes folder. In DIALux EVO we have three types of your sky. We have clean sky, so you have only sun without any clouds. Then you have average sky, you have some clouds on your sun, and then you have overcast sky where you have only the cloudy sky. Okay, let's click to clear sky and then click to calculation. So when your calculation is finished, you can go to the 3D view, to the story mode, and then you can see how sunlight goes to your space. And this is extremely important, because sometimes it influences on location of your building, on the size of your windows, and even on the types of luminaires and the arrangement of the luminaires which you select for your project. Sometimes this daylight calculation is extremely important. And also you can select here the date and time when you want to see how light distributes in your space. Let's go here, select this view. Okay, and let's click to views and save this view. Yeah, so we have here clear sky. Then let's go to the light scenes, and here you can find some luminance data which you can use for your project and for presentation for your client. Let's go here, and you see that here we have like 5000 lux, If you go to average sky mode, you should, and when we make calculation, so you see here less quantity of flux, so we have 1000 lux less, we have just 4600 lux. And let's save this view also, save new view. So this is like average sky, and then we can go to the last mode. We go to light scenes and then click to overcast sky, select, and then click to calculation. As you can see that overcast sky is the fastest calculation mode here. Here you can see your daylight factor effective area for your room. Then you can see here lux level, and also you can see here ratio between minimum and average lux level. So you can make like a lighting calculation using this way, using these standards. Let's double click on our average sky view and click here save new view. So we have here overcast sky, and let's go to our documentation. Here we have images, and with our images we have these layout alternatives, and in this layout alternatives we have this template with the three pictures for comparison. Extremely useful when you work with these with comparison, so you want to compare some scenes or some types of sky in your project. So let's click here clear sky, average sky, and overcast sky. Let's click to apply, and here on one page you can see three types of your sky. Also you can look through this display options, and let you can click here on the false colors, and you can see this this false colors distribution in your project. So here we have like 500 lux with the red color, and you can find some information, lighting information for your project as well here. I hope you like this video. Subscribe to my channel, subscribe to our Telegram Lighting Design International community so you can join us, ask questions and answer the questions as well, so we can communicate there. And see you in the next tutorial. Click the bell icon not to miss our new videos, and give a thumbs up to this video.